Hi, my name is Guy Wallace, and in this PAC video short, we're going to cover the gap prioritizations of the curriculum architecture design process, a component of the PAC processes of training and development. PAC is an acronym. It stands for Performance-Based, Accelerated, Customer and Stakeholder-Driven Training and Development of Any Blend. Training and development paths include events on them. Each event is kind of the equivalent of a book that has many chapters. The number and naming of the chapters doesn't show up on the path, but if one looked at the event specifications, one could see that. The chart on the right in this diagram identifies all of the modules, the chapters of the books. The books are on the left on the path. Gaps, those events that have either a partial red circle or nothing in the circle, need to be prioritized. If the project steering team doesn't prioritize them for development and acquisition, they remain as unstructured on-the-job training, what today is known as informal learning. We might be able to identify where in the learning path one needs to learn something, but the business decision may be that it's not worthy, it doesn't have enough return on the investment to actually build formal content of any blend, of any media, of any mode, and to leave it as is, with nothing, or with partial content. The learners will have to learn this by hook or by crook once they get out on the job. What we've done as a part of the PAC process is we've identified where in the learning continuum one might learn that, but we may not provide any content to support that learning. It may be that we expect the learner to ask their neighbor, to ask their boss, to ask somebody on one of their teams to help them with changing the toner on the copy machine, or utilizing the fax machine, or learning how to use Yammer. I've been practicing, publishing, and presenting on these methods since 1982. My recent book, Six Pack, covers all of this in great detail.